folks, welcome back to Game Geeks. I'm your host, Kurt Wiegel. Today's episode, we're reviewing a pair of games that sort of round out the Scion line from White Wolf Games. Scion Demigod and Scion God. It takes what happened in Scion Hero, which was you found out you were the offspring of any one of the classical Egyptian, Greek, Norse, Aztec, Japanese, or Voodoo pantheon, and in Scion Demigod, turns it up to 11. You're no longer just a mortal with some supernatural powers. You're now a half-divine being. You have a lot more power. It expands out the boons and the knacks that and sort of what you can do, but it also turns your villains that you're fighting, the Titan spawn, and in some cases even minor Titans themselves, also turns those up to 11. And then you get to Scion God, when you finally ascend to full-on godhood. Wow. This turns it and takes it up to 115. So now, there's no getting around this. How many of us have always said, man, I wish I could play a god. I think that would be so cool to have all that power. Raise your hands. I'll fess up to it. I did too. This lets you do that. But it's one of those, be very careful what you wish for. The game is more complicated than I would like. You have a lot of things you have to keep up with. One of them is your sort of your legend pool and your legend rating. And the more legend you have, the more powerful you are. And the more points in your legend pool, the more powerful you are. But the problem is, the more legendary you get, the more easy it is for your legend to get tied in with everyone around you. Fate can be a fickle witch that way. So you have to sort of be careful how you interact with the mortal world. The powers you get in this are absolutely stunning. Aside from Scion Demigod, which introduces the Atlantean pantheon for the purposes of their game that they include in here, it doesn't introduce any new pantheons to you. There are some options for that popping up online. They've produced a web-only production of the Tuatha De Danann, which ties into some of the Celtic mythology. For those of you who know how to say that, and I butchered it, my apologies. In Scion Hero, it gave you an idea of how the world worked. In Scion Demigod, it gives you an idea of how Underworld works, how the different pantheons view the different underworlds, because sort of the conceit for the game is that the gods have gone silent in Demigod, and you have to descend down into the underworld to find out what's going on. In Scion God, folks, you're up there in the heavens, or whatever your particular pantheon calls it, with your parents. And at first, it sort of has you operating as sort of the go-to people or the minions. I mean, you're lesser gods. Obviously, your character's probably not going to go toe-to-toe with Ares or with Thor unless they're really powerful or they have a death wish. Although you can get there. You can get there. The game also includes the stock set of six characters, advancing them from hero to demigod to god, and an adventure. Probably the back half to back third of each of these books is all the adventure that they provide. It does seem to be tailored for the established characters, but it wouldn't take much work on the part of the storyteller to kind of pull bits of that out and insert their own plot lines in there and their own characters. This takes it all the way through. There is some talk that they will be releasing another book in this called Scion Ragnarok, which sort of deals with the end of the world, specifically through the lens of the Asgard pantheon. It'll be interesting to see. Like I said, I love the ideas in this. I love the concept, and I love the fact that it's basically supernatural superheroes. What I don't love is that it uses a modification of the White Wolf engine, but you end up throwing around a lot of dice and a lot of power points and different pools to keep track of, that to me, it gets a little complicated. I'm old. I have a family. I have a job. It's kind of harder for me to keep track of some of this in my head and figure out the right way to structure it. If that works for you, if I were in college again, I would probably be eating this up with a spoon. It is a really good game line. It's just a little cumbersome for me at this stage in my life. But if you want a game that lets you play the offspring to full-on deities and have all the powers and responsibilities pertaining thereto, this is a game for you. For Game Geeks, I'm your host, Kurt Wiegel. Good day and good gaming.